WCNC Charlotte, this is Flashpoint, where power and politics collide and the tough questions get asked and answered.
Thanks for joining us here on Flashpoint. I'm Ben Thompson. This week, an interview you'll only see right here on WCNC Charlotte, one-on-one with Senator Tom Tillis. Recently, he revealed a prostate cancer diagnosis. Even though it's considered a very treatable cancer, it can still be deadly. Every 15 minutes, a man in America dies from it. It claimed the life of my dad last fall. A few weeks ago, Senator Tillis had surgery, and now he's already back to work. We chatted about the disease, treatment options, and stopping the stigma surrounding prostate cancer. First and foremost, how are you feeling?
Feel great. Came out of surgery with the typical post-operative challenges, but that lasted for about a week. And then I got a great pathology report from my urologist that looks like we're in good shape going forward.
Back at work already?
Yep. Full schedule last week in D.C., full schedule this week, actually through the weekend. So this is a 7-day week for me. And back to a normal routine. I'm not able to be active. That's the thing that's killing me. I'm not going to be able to be on a mountain bike for probably 2 months. And I am hiking. I got 6 miles in yesterday. So probably more than my doctor advised. But
hey, that's better than most of us. So please. In your initial statement, you talked about early detection, and you said, never imagined that I even had cancer. How much of a surprise was this for you?
It was a surprise. I do my annual physical and went in last October. And usually I look forward to the physical because my wife always tells me I need to eat less meat or something. And so she always worries about cholesterol, the blood counts. Yeah. Comes back in the 98th percentile. Everything's checking off. Got a cardiac CT scan, zero plaque for a 60-year-old. That's pretty good news. And so checking down the list.
You're feeling good, pretty good about it.
Feeling good. Then he gets to the PSA test and said that it was almost twice what it was 4 years ago. So it had gone up from 2.75 to 4 and now 6.5. He said probably still nothing at age 60. That's not a alarm bell, but we had to look into it. Then I went to the urologist, got another PSA test, got the biopsy, and found that I had cancer in half of the prostate gland.
From what I understand, PSA is somewhat relative to a person. That's why they measure it over time to see how much it changes.
That's right. It can go up and down. Different things. If people are taking human growth hormones, testosterone supplements, it can elevate your PSA. But testosterone is what they call the jet fuel of prostate cancer. It's what causes it to spread. And then through the surgery that I had, it reduces that. I've got a PSA test, a follow-up scheduled for about 2 weeks, and I'm hopeful that it's going to be down to the almost undetectable level. That's frequently the case.
As you know, and as many Americans now know this, because I think it's the second most common cancer for men, there's several different treatments. You have radiation, you have cryotherapy, was what my father had, hormone therapy, you mentioned the testosterone. Why surgery?
Well, I looked at all the, and quite honestly, a part of it had to do with my official duties. I had to find one that I was willing to accept the risk of the side effects, but also able to do it within the contours of a tough schedule. I was talking with doctors when I was trying to, at one point they were suggesting a second biopsy to be absolutely certain before surgery that they were going after the gland in the right way. And I started thinking about the prospects of having to delay the surgery, get another biopsy, putting me into year-end votes, and finally just made a decision that was comfortable to me. A lot of people do the beam therapy that is a treatment that takes about a month of 2-hour sessions every day, 7 days a week. The bead therapy, the radiation pellets is another option. Cryotherapy, HIFU therapy, which is not authorized in the United States, but in Canada. There's a lot out there, and I think a lot of people need to understand that it's moving at a rapid pace. So I was just talking to someone today, 10 years from now, when he'll start need to be tested for PSA, he'll have far more options and probably far fewer side effects.
What was your family's reaction to the news?
Mine, my wife was, I think, the typical spouse that was very upset, and more so than me. It was when the doctor called me up with the biopsy results, I said, okay, now what? Because I at least knew that if you treat it aggressively, that you had a lot of options. So I was already in project mode to figure out how we beat this, but it took my wife and some of my family members a little bit more time.
I know family history is such a big deal when it comes to this. Do you know if you had any family history?
Yeah, I did. My brother had an elevated PSA when he, and I think at 50 years old, so he had his prostate out at 51. And that was 7 years ago, and he has no trace. But there is, that triggers a likelihood that my son, my nephews may be at higher risk. I'm already telling them, listen to your doctor, but you'll probably want to start PSA testing sooner than most, which is around 50 years old.
Doctors feel good about your long-term prognosis?
When I went in for my post-operative review and to get the catheter out, which was another story all in it, of itself, but he described my pathology report as perfect. And what he meant by that was the pathology report was consistent with the biopsy. So the first biopsy really was a good gauge on what they needed to treat. And all of the cancer cells, where they found it, whether or not they also dissected 6 lymph nodes, found no evidence that it had metastasized to the lymph nodes. And most other research looks like I got it early and contained it.
Well, one of the reasons we wanted to do this story, and I think probably the same for you, is that there's stigma might be the wrong word, but guys just don't go around talking about their prostates, much less prostate.
I do.
And just ask
my staff.
And you are. I mean, are you hoping to take away some of that stigma so that men are having these conversations?
100%. Look, you know, I've spent a lot of time in behavioral health and removing the stigma for around behavioral health. One of the reasons why a lot of people with mental health issues do not come forward is because of the stigma. Now, this is something that's, you know, unique to men. There are all kinds of side effects that you may have to deal with, short-term or long-term. And it just seems silly to me to be embarrassed by getting any kind of disease. It'd be like being embarrassed for getting the flu. Your mindset has to be to attack it. The most dangerous thing, and I've had several people contact me after I went public and say, you coming out and saying what you did got my husband back to his primary care physician after getting a PSA of 8 2 years ago. That is really getting up to a potentially dangerous, aggressive cancer. So I said, get the PSA test. It's not like it used to be. You know, they had the digital exam.
Yes.
Not fun. Think Chevy Chase.
Yeah, yeah. Now, this is just a blood test, right?
Right. It's a blood test. They take a part of the blood that they do with your annual physical. They take a blood test and they track it over time. If you're at around a 2, they're going to monitor it. If you're at a 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, they're probably going to recommend other options, potentially a biopsy. But there's also a lot of competing literature around the best procedure. And the fact of the matter is, the survivability rate for radiation therapy and for surgery is very, very similar. You just need to take a look at the potential side effects and pick the one that's most comfortable for your circumstances.
A cancer diagnosis can be life-changing for a lot of folks. Has it been life-changing for you?
Well, it was life-changing the day of the surgery, because I had the Da Vinci, the robot surgery, which has really become probably the most common now. And I'm telling you, just to do the surgery, to have your waistline expand 3 inches over the course of 5 hours, and then deal with, I probably put on 7 or 8 pounds. I got to start working that off, but I can't get active now. So, I had a medical challenge back in 2007 and was able to beat it back. The only serious health challenge I'd ever had in my life. And physically active. I was reading today trying to figure out how I can push the envelope on the physical activities I like to do. I want to be jumping out of a plane on my 61st birthday, and that's not till August, so I think that'll happen too.
Well, George H.W. Bush was doing it till, what, he was 90 or something? So you still have 30 more years to do it. Does it change at all how you view your job and your responsibilities?
I don't know. I think that the job that I have gives me the opportunity to increase awareness, but really didn't. You know, I mean, honestly, through this entire process, you have to keep in mind, I was diagnosed with cancer pre-impeachment and pre-insurrection. But the interesting thing was, there were several over the course of time that I'd gotten the cancer diagnosis. I mean, there were some days where it may be late in the day where I'd have a conversation that reminded me of the fact that I had cancer, had a lot of other responsibilities to focus on, and this is something that I didn't want it to consume me. I wanted to really make sure that I was reading, talking to a lot of people, and getting a lot of advice. And one of the great things that's come out of this are the number of members who have come up to me who have, some have chosen not to go public, a couple did, sharing stories.
Finally, I mean, I know they often say that prostate cancer is something that you usually die with, not necessarily die from, but I know they estimate about 34,000 people will die from it this year. My father died from it last year. What is your message to people who might be like, oh, it's prostate cancer, it's treatable, it's not that serious?
Well, it's only treatable if you get it treated, and it's only treatable if you get it diagnosed. The doctors say it's the best cancer you can get if you're going to get one, but it doesn't mean, even with my positive pathology report, there's no guarantee that there aren't prostate cancer cells somewhere else in my body. But because we've reduced the risk of it spreading, now it's just a matter of managing it. And so I think the real key is just to treat it like any other challenge, confront it. The odds are in your favor. The odds are stacked against you if you ignore it, if you don't seek treatment. Yeah. But if you do, and you just lean into it, even the stuff, man, if the the 7 days after the surgery, I just look at that as, that could be a 7-day investment in a lifetime that won't end as a result of prostate cancer. So even if I do have it, I believe at this point it's treatable. I move on.
There you heard it. Well, to learn more about prostate cancer, you can check out the National Cancer Institute's website. You can visit that website. It's cancer.gov. Still to come, though, this morning, more of my conversation with Senator Tillis. He had a few other topics he wanted to discuss. Is Washington as dysfunctional as it seems? The good work getting done, he says, we never hear about.